Good day from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will discuss how a drug's pharmacodynamics and pharmacokinetics together help determine the dosing of a drug. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to define something called PK/PD. Visualize two PK/PD models, the direct and indirect models, and distinguish whether drug efficacy is best predicted through Cmax or area under the curve measures of exposure. PK/PD is the relationship between pharmacokinetics and pharmacodynamics. PK/PD defines the connection of ideas like CP time and area under the curve from PK and effect versus time from pharmacodynamics. Understanding PK/PD helps determine the dosing regimen of a drug. There are two PK/PD models, the direct and indirect model. In the direct PK/PD model, both CP and PD, the effect, move together. If CP rises, then effect rises. If CP falls, then effect falls. We can see this in the graph to the right. The x-axis is time. The y-axis is either CP or effect. We can see that as the CP time curve in blue rises, the effect time curve also rises. As the CP time curve falls, effect also falls. The peaks of both curves align on the x-axis. Antimicrobials and ion channel binding drugs often follow the direct PK/PD model. Higher drug concentrations lead to a higher antibacterial, antifungal, or antiparasitic activity, the PD effect. Ion channel ligands cause rapid cell membrane polarization changes, which lead to immediate responses, immediate effects in a cell. In the indirect PK/PD model, CP and PD, the effect, do not move together. The peaks of the CP and effect curves do not align on the x-axis. We can see this in the graph to the right. Only after the CP time curve has peaked does the effect time curve achieve its peak. So the PD curve lags behind the CP time curve. Sometimes people call the indirect model the delayed PK/PD model. Many drugs follow the indirect model. Many drugs act on a target that is far upstream of the response event in a biological pathway. An example would be a drug that affects gene expression. Some drugs have a distribution lag, and CP plasma concentration is not predictive of drug concentration at the target. Some drugs form active metabolites. So again, CP, plasma concentration of the parent drug, may not accurately relate to the effect from all biologically active compounds. Understanding whether a compound operates under the direct or indirect PK/PD model can help determine how the compound should be dosed for an ideal effect. Another PK/PD-related question is whether the effect of a drug is mostly determined by Cmax or area under the curve. Both Cmax and AUC are methods of measuring drug exposure, but which one is more important for drug action, the PD effect? This question can often be answered through a drug fractionation study, in which one group is given a single large dose of a drug and another group is given multiple smaller doses. The total mass of the doses is identical, so AUC values will be the same, but Cmax will be much lower for the second group. The graph on the right shows the CP time curves for these two groups. The large doses in blue and the multiple smaller doses are in red. Cmax for the blue line is higher, but the AUC values are the same. If both dosing groups show the same biological effect, then the PD of the drug is driven by AUC, and AUC will be the more informative method for determining drug exposure and planning drug dosing. We have defined PK/PD and visualized both the direct and indirect models. We also discussed a dose fractionation study, which can determine whether the effect of a drug is driven by Cmax or AUC. All this information is helpful in planning a drug dosing regimen. Thank you for watching to the end. PK-PD relationships are a bit more advanced of a topic and can be more difficult to appreciate. If you have any questions, please share them in the comments section below the video. Take care.